I'm here with Congresswoman newly elected Myra Flores. We're actually in the heart of South Texas in McAllen. When I interviewed you last year, you were very well known in South Texas, but outside of that, no one really knew much about your campaign. But 1 year later, you're now making history. You flipped a seat Republican, first time in 100 years, first Mexican-born member of Congress, and now you've been seen as kind of a rising star of the GOP. Why are we seeing Latino voters, particularly in South Texas, move towards the GOP? And do you believe it's a trend that could follow nationally as well?
Absolutely. And I believe that the reason why this district hadn't been flipped is we didn't have the funding, to be honest with you. We didn't have the funding, which is very important to spread the message across the district. And because this district is already conservative. We're all about faith, family, and hard work. That's who we are by nature. So I believe that because of my story, being born in Mexico, coming here to the United States, working in the cotton fields, you know, working at a very young age, and then graduating from high school, becoming a respiratory care practitioner. I'm a proud Border Patrol wife as well, and a mother of four young children. That's the American dream. That's who we are here in South Texas. And my story resonated with the people of Texas District 34. And through hard work and dedication and the funding, we were able to flip this district that had not been flipped for over 100 years.
Yeah, it's fascinating because, you know, we saw your historic win. Last year, the city of McAllen, I mean, they voted in the very first Republican mayor with Javier Villalobos, first time. We're keeping an eye close to Cassie Garcia, Monica de la Cruz, who are Latina women running with the GOP. Now, Myra, you got to get to work fast because, you know, you have a re-election in November. You're running against a Democrat, Vicente Gonzalez, in a district that does favor the Democrats. Basically, from now till November, what is your strategy to basically secure that win? But also, he ended up calling you an unqualified opponent and a pawn chosen by the Republican Party for a race they pour millions of dollars into a seat that's only going to hold for 6 months. So first, what's the strategy and your response to his comments on that?
The strategy stays the same. The lines don't change the values of the district. And it did not get easier, you know, for Vicente. It got harder for Vicente. For me, it got easier. Why? Now I'm the incumbent. Now I'm the congresswoman for Texas District 34. He's not the congressman here. He's a congressman in another district. He's jumping in this district because he thought that it was going to be an easier win for him. So it got harder for him. It did not get harder for me. I believe that if I continue to focus on the issues that matter here in our district, the gas, the grocery prices, healthcare, things that we care every single day, that we're going to win the re-election through hard work and dedication, and because we're focused on the people here in Texas District 34 and not the nonsense in Washington, Latinx. And he believes that I don't have the qualifications. Why? Because I was born in Mexico? That's what he said. And because he was born here in Texas. These are people that claim that they're for immigrants. These are people that claim that they're for women, for people of color. They're not supporting me. They just use immigrants for political power. I support immigration. And that is why my focus is going to be in improving the legal process. So the good people that want to come here to work hard for the American dream don't have to go through literally through hell. For the American dream. I want them to come here where it's safer, where they don't have to pay a cartel thousands of dollars. That's the way we're going to be able to help immigrants and keep the American people safe as well.
I want to get to this one right here, Myra. You know, you're newly elected, but you had a Republican senator in your state, John Cornyn. He introduced the Safer Communities Act, which is legislation to help states implement the red flag laws, which removes firearms from those deemed unfit. That's according to the legislation. And it funds violence prevention and mental health programs. It expands background checks for gun buyers under 21. You know, this is a very controversial topic with the Uvalde shooting that happened in the state as well. You were the only board representative from Texas to vote against it, which President Biden did sign into law. Why did you vote against it?
Because I believe that our children's safety is worth more than $3,000. Each school would only get $3,000. I'm a mother of four young children, and my children's safety is worth a lot more than that. We send $80 billion to Ukraine, and we cannot invest not $1 billion for our children's safety. Only $300 is being invested for school safety in the entire country. That's an average of $3,000 per school. That's an insult. And that is why I voted no. Nothing else. Because I believe that it's an insult and that we deserve better. Why only $3,000? Why not invest billions of dollars? And their answer was, that's too much money. Wow. So we can send $80 billion to Ukraine and not invest $80 billion towards our school safety. I'm nothing without my kids. They mean the world to me. And I know that our kids mean the world to all parents. And that is why I'm going to be working on legislation that focuses on school safety and that billions of dollars will be invested in school safety and not $3,000. That's not going to make a difference.
And school safety as in terms of, would you support armed guards? What's your vision for school safety?
That's exactly what we need, armed guards. We need to be prepared to face evil. Evil doesn't care about laws. We can create all these laws, but name me a criminal that respects laws. They don't care about the law. So we need to be ready. We need to have police officers in every school, trained police officers, because we cannot allow for what happened in Uvalde to ever happen again. I cannot imagine what these parents are going through, and I'm heartbroken. And that's the reason why I felt so insulted by this bill, because $3,000, that does nothing to protect our children. And that is the reason why I voted no, and that is why my focus will be to be working on legislation that does focus in investing billions of dollars in our school safety.
And one of the key issues that basically led to your victory, an issue that you hammered, is the issue of the border here in South Texas and illegal immigration. As you know, Vice President Kamala Harris, she's been named the border czar. What message, if you do have one, have for the vice president and so far in how she's dealing with the border to this day?
Well, she's useless. She's done absolutely nothing. Biden is useless. They have done absolutely nothing for us. They don't care about immigrants. Because of them is that we have this border crisis. Because of them, people are dying. Because of them, we have a serious problem in this country with child sex trafficking. I think this shouldn't be political. This is about human lives, innocent children. I don't understand why the Democrat Party continues to encourage people to come here illegally, knowing that they're going to go through such dangerous journey. Why not help them come here legally? Why not focus on the legal process and help them come here the right way? Why do they want them to go through such dangerous journey? Why? Because it's all about politics for them. For me, it's not about politics. I don't care about the party. I care about people. And that's the way it should be. I don't care who did voted for this and who did voted for this. No, I'm going to do what's right. I'm going to do what's right for Texas District 34, not what's right for the party.
Well, Congresswoman Myra Flores, thank you so much for sitting down with us at the Daily Caller.